Well, that's the problem. The James Webb Space Telescope is upsetting the apple cart. All of a sudden, we realize that we may have to rewrite all the textbooks about the beginning of the universe. Now, it takes many billions of years to create a galaxy, like the Milky Way galaxy, with 100 billion stars, many billions of years old. But the James Webb Telescope has identified six galaxies that exist half a billion years after the Big Bang, that are up to 10 times bigger than the Milky Way galaxy.
In a stunning blow to the established theories of the Big Bang, the James Webb Space Telescope has once again rocked the scientific community. Since its launch on Christmas Day 2021, this superstar telescope has unveiled the universe in a manner that defies all expectations. And now, it has discovered six galaxies that shouldn't exist, defying our cosmological models. These galaxies, formed just 500 million years after the Big Bang, are more developed and packed with stars than anything we've seen before. And just when we thought the shock couldn't escalate any further, researchers from the University of Minnesota have uncovered something even more perplexing. Among these celestial anomalies lies a galaxy so mind-bogglingly bizarre that it might force us to reevaluate everything we thought we knew. Let's find out more in today's video.
Now we say we don't understand how galaxies are born. Let's make a telescope to help us. So we spec the next generation space telescope after Hubble to be exquisitely tuned to show us galaxies being born. And we expect it to show us galaxies at the end of the Dark Ages, at the birth of objects in the universe. So we design and build this telescope, the James Webb Space Telescope.
Imagine a telescope so powerful, so cutting edge, that it makes the Hubble Space Telescope look like a tiny dot in the vastness of space. The James Webb Space Telescope is a technological marvel, a mind-blowing piece of equipment designed to push the boundaries of our knowledge about the universe. In fact, the JWST is no ordinary telescope. It's a space-bound sentinel, perched high above the Earth, gazing into the depths of space with unbridled curiosity. This cosmic marvel can gather a mind-boggling 10 times more light than the mighty Hubble telescope. It's like having a superhuman eye that can peer into the darkest corners of the cosmos. But that's not all. The JWST has a secret weapon, an affinity for the infrared spectrum. It's like having a pair of sunglasses that lets you see things that are invisible to the naked eye. You see, the universe has its own language, a symphony of light, colors, and wavelengths. And the JWST speaks that language fluently. By harnessing the power of infrared light, it can look at hidden cosmic treasures, revealing secrets that were previously obscured from view. It's like having a backstage pass to the greatest cosmic show on Earth. As we marvel at the JWST's ability to speak the universe's language, it's crucial to realize that our journey doesn't begin with the telescope's groundbreaking capabilities. To truly grasp the mysteries of the early universe, we must rewind time to a point when the concepts of time and space themselves were non-existent.
In the early universe, go back to the Big Bang, and you have this cauldron of matter and energy. Well, we don't have stars yet. We don't have galaxies yet, this organizing principle of stars as they gather into cities. No, it's just matter and energy. And it takes a while for the expanding universe to cool so that matter can coalesce to make stars and ultimately galaxies.
Imagine rewinding the clock of the universe to a moment called the Big Bang. This mind-blowing event marked the birth of the entire universe. It started from an unimaginably hot and dense point. But here's the mind-bending part. At that moment, there was no time or space like we experience in our everyday lives. To understand what happened during this incredible time, we rely on a theory called cosmic inflation. It suggests that the universe expanded rapidly right after the Big Bang, like a balloon inflating incredibly fast. This expansion created the foundation for everything we see in the universe today. During inflation, space itself expanded faster than the speed of light. It's like the universe hit the fast forward button, doubling in size at least 90 times in the blink of an eye, from subatomic to golf ball sized in an instant. As the universe continued to grow, it cooled down and matter started to form. A mere 1 second after the Big Bang, the universe was filled with an incredible mix of particles, like neutrons, protons, electrons, anti-electrons, photons, and neutrinos. But here's the catch. For around 380,000 years, the universe was just too darn hot for light to shine. It was like a cosmic sauna. However, as the universe cooled down, something magical happened. After those long years, atoms finally had a chance to form, and light could finally shine its way through the universe. But don't get too comfortable with the lights on, because shortly after that, darkness took over. You see, no stars or any bright objects had formed yet, plunging the universe into a mysterious cosmic blackout. Fast forward to 400 million years after the Big Bang, when the universe was emerging from its dark ages. This period is known as the Age of Reionization. During this time, which lasted for over 500 million years, the first stars began to appear, and galaxies started to form. Scientists believed that galaxies took about a billion years to fully develop and reach their adolescent stage, 1 to 2 billion years after the Big Bang. However, the James Webb Space Telescope has made an astonishing discovery. It has found not just one, but 6 fully formed galaxies that existed only 500 million years after the Big Bang. This finding poses a challenge to our current understanding of galactic evolution. Using groundbreaking observations from the JWST, a team led by the University of Minnesota delved more than 13 billion years into the past. They uncovered a tiny galaxy, one of the smallest ever discovered at this distance, that was producing new stars at an incredibly high rate for its size. This remarkable galaxy could provide valuable insights into the galaxies that emerged shortly after the birth of the universe.
That's right. Some people say it's an optical illusion. You see, according to Einstein, gravity can act like glass. The glass, of course, you can make a magnifying glass. With gravity, you too can bend space and time to create a gravity microwave, a magnifying lens. So you think that these galaxies are huge when they're actually baby galaxies.
Although this galaxy is roughly a million times smaller in volume than our Milky Way, it continues to form stars at a similar rate. Scientists explain that the galaxies present in the early universe were vastly different from the ones we observe nearby today. By studying these early galaxies, we hope to unravel the mystery of how and when the first stars and galaxies emerged from the universe's dark ages. As time goes on, the results from JWST's observations continue to astound us. The telescope is revealing that the early universe was even more peculiar and intriguing than we could have imagined. Not only has the Webb discovered these early galaxies, but it has also stumbled upon an ancient black hole, one of the oldest known in the universe.
Now, I personally think that the solution to the problem is these are not baby galaxies at all. They're actually monstrous black holes. Black holes that formed after the instant of creation. That's baffling scientists because they don't fit in the normal sequence of the birth of a galaxy.
Scientists believe this supermassive black hole, which dwarfs our sun by a staggering 10 million times, existed at the center of a galaxy just 570 million years after the birth of the universe. This makes it the earliest growing supermassive black hole ever detected. This black hole was found within one of the earliest galaxies ever detected, previously known as EGSY-8P7, but now renamed CEERS-1019. Its discovery could provide valuable insights into one of the great mysteries of the early universe. How did black holes in the cosmic dawn grow to such enormous sizes in such a short period of time? Scientists were initially studying CEERS-1019 as part of their investigation into the light produced by star formation in the early universe. This light, called Lyman alpha emission, is believed to be generated by the ionization of neutral hydrogen due to star formation activity. During the early universe, a fog of neutral hydrogen prevented light from traveling freely until this hydrogen was ionized, allowing light to propagate. This epoch of reionization, as it's called, is still not fully understood, but we know it occurred within the first billion years after the Big Bang, 13.8 billion years ago. However, observing that far back into the early universe is extremely challenging. CEERS-1019, along with a few other super early galaxies, presents an excellent opportunity for research because they are relatively bright. The galaxy was first identified in Hubble data back in 2015 and was, at that time, the most distant galaxy observed. Further observations confirmed its existence, but detailed information remained elusive. The earliest light in the universe has shifted so far into the infrared part of the spectrum due to the expansion of the universe that we need a powerful and dedicated infrared instrument, like the JWST, to investigate them. When the JWST came into the picture, CEERS-1019, being the brightest of the Hubble galaxies from this epoch, became an obvious target. The telescope focused on the galaxy for just 1 hour, utilizing all four of its instruments, and returned an abundance of data. The astrophysicists involved in the research were amazed by the results, realizing that with the JWST, they could see a whole new portion of the spectrum and explore galaxies in the early stages of the universe like never before. As scientists delved into the vast amount of data gathered by the James Webb Space Telescope, they stumbled upon a fascinating revelation. Among the expected light signals produced by star formation, there was an unexpected presence, a broad emission feature that is typically associated with active galactic nuclei, or AGN. This finding sparked intrigue and curiosity among researchers specializing in AGN studies. Active galactic nuclei are powerful cosmic phenomena found at the centers of galaxies. They are fueled by supermassive black holes, which draw in and devour surrounding matter, emitting intense radiation in the process. AGN emits various types of high-energy radiation, including X-rays and gamma rays, which reveal their active nature. The coexistence of AGN-related emission features alongside the signatures of star formation within the same galaxy is an intriguing phenomenon. Typically, in the early universe, galaxies are expected to predominantly emit either AGN-related light or light resulting from star formation. Witnessing both in a single galaxy challenges current understanding and raises questions about the interplay between these cosmic processes. Researchers are now presented with an intriguing puzzle to solve. The presence of AGN-related emission lines hints at the influence of a supermassive black hole, but the majority of the observed light still appears to be dominated by the star-forming regions within the galaxy. Unraveling the intricacies of this dual emission phenomenon holds the potential to shed light on the complex mechanisms governing galaxy formation and evolution.
Just to be fair to us, we built this telescope for this purpose, to help us understand the birth of galaxies.
The discovery further emphasizes the evolving nature of our understanding of the early universe. The rapid advancement in observational capabilities, exemplified by the James Webb Space Telescope, continually challenges existing theories and calls for reevaluation. scientists are now compelled to return to the drawing board, armed with this newfound knowledge, to refine our understanding of the cosmic tapestry that has captivated humanity for centuries. But we need to be cautious about drawing big conclusions based on the initial data from the James Webb Space Telescope. It's possible that the data may not be completely accurate, or our current understanding of how the universe formed might be incomplete. To truly understand what's happened with these unusual structures in the universe, we need more detailed and reliable data. A thorough survey called Cosmos Web, currently underway with the James Webb Telescope, should provide us with a clearer picture. Even if these structures turn out to be real, there are many astrophysical explanations that don't require any new laws of physics. It's possible that basic forces like gravity and electromagnetism, along with the interactions between stars and gas, can explain why these galaxies exist with their large sizes and brightness. It's important to approach these discoveries with caution and let the evidence guide us. Rushing to make extraordinary claims without solid evidence can lead us astray. The goal is to conduct responsible and rigorous science, ensuring that our understanding aligns with the actual observations. But what if the Big Bang Theory turns out to be a cosmic curveball? Share your views in the comments. Like, subscribe, and watch more content like this here.